Hello everybody and welcome back to my space mining adventures in Eve on Rhine with me. A couple of things. One, I've decided that this ugly motherfucker should probably be replaced with some other ugly motherfucker, because despite it being free, I think we'd be better off with a real cargo ship. So I'm going to strip all the fittings off this biznatch. Because those same percentage-based cargo modifiers would do much better on an Iteron. It is a Galente freight ship, which is what we should be getting instead of that, stupid badger. Badgers are dumb anyway. They don't even have mushrooms. Anyway, this is what we want, the Iteron Mark IV. Can't fly it yet, that'll take 5 seconds to learn. But we need to get one, and they sell for about 2 mil. Could cover that in cash, but I think we'd be better off building one. So, what we want to do is find a contract for someone selling a blueprint for an Iteron Mark 4 or 5 or whatever. Excuse me, what are you talking about? I just looked and there were a bunch of them. Why you lying, game? Iteron, Iteroth, Iter outside. Game's lying. Don't know why. I had it searching locally, and we don't want to search locally. So, we're going to find an Iteron. Here are the Iteron blueprints. They should all be one-run blueprints, and they should all be roughly the same quality. Now, we could get one for 250,000, but that's 20 jumps away, and fuck that. All these other ones are 350-ish, 1,000, 11 jumps away. This one's 375, 5 jumps away, and I'm pretty sure it's safe, because it's in Jita, which is... Well, okay, the safety of that is questionable. Arguably, we could crash our computer just going there. Anyway, we are going to view the contract, and... I don't know if I can... fill this out when I'm not there, but I'm gonna go ahead and set a course there. 5 jumps from here to Jita, and I've also been doing a little looking around for a new home for us, and I think I might have found something nice. So there we go. Jita is there, and we're just going boop, 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 boop. Shouldn't be a big problem. Take our butts over there and grab one of those. Now, these are not easy to make from a resource cost perspective, because we're going to have to buy 10 Megasite and 45 Zidrine. We should be able to cover everything except for those and the Isogen. I think we've got the Noxium covered with some of that Pyrex or whatever. The viscous crap we took care of earlier. So, I think I'll accept this contract. You are about to accept the contract. You have to pay... money. You will receive a thing. Yes. Contract is for the Forge region. You can only access outside. Oh. Fine. I'll just go there then. be that way. Well, it looks like that's a reason to go there. Oh, and I don't have a destination set. Wonderful. Things are going great. Set a destination. Alright, so I'll switch over to my... I guess we'll use the Theseus for this, in case anybody tries to fuck with us. And I'll remember to put my drones back on it. I loaded up the Rocinante again for a full mining kit, and that should be good. Here we go. Welcome to Jita, Eve's version of hell. 952 people hanging out in this system right now. Hopefully they're not all right outside this particular plant. Good, good, good. Just a couple... Oh my god. those guys look mean. They're wanted. No? What? Russian? Something? I don't know. I better get in this station before something... accidentally kills me. Dots. We need more dots. More dots. Many dots. Docking permission requested. Let's see. We should be able to grab this. I probably didn't need to come all the way here for this, too. Well, okay. I'm glad you accepted me, but... Oh, wow. Somebody had a skull on their face there. That's scary. Skull faces. Current station... So these are all the same, except for this one is the same, but different. I suppose I should look at these, see if the runs are any different. Material efficiency 10, time efficiency 20. And this one's a little more expensive at the same exact thing. So we'll get this one. I accept you. Yes. Bang, bang. Done and done. So now, here we have the Iteron Mark IV blueprint, which we're going to toss into the Theseus. And I suppose I should look at some of the resources we're going to need to see if we can get them cheaper here while we're here. I'll take a look at that. As somewhat predicted, the cheapest place in the system is the one we're at. So we can buy the 10 megasite here. Hopefully we can carry it all. I don't think it should be terribly heavy. Yeah. We're good. And then the only other ones we have to worry about are the Zedrine and Isogen. I don't know if we'll have enough space to carry the Isogen, but we need to buy the Zedrine for sure. 45 of that, and the cheapest place in the system is here. Cheapest place in the region, really. 45, that's a pretty penny. But it's worth it. And let's see, where's my inventory at? There it went. So, wait a minute, did I just buy 45 megasite? Oops. God damn it. Stupid me? Oh well, we got extras. Maybe we can take it back and sell it somewhere else. Wait a minute, this is above regional average. Oh right, I didn't look at this actually. To see where the cheapest would be. Okay, well I don't know why that's above the regional average, considering it's the fucking cheapest in the area. Whatever. Maybe I shouldn't buy it here. Well, fuck. God damn it. Yeah, I think we're just gonna go home before I make any more mistakes. Mistakes again? No. Not from me. We safely made it home with our blueprint and our way too much megasite. I sold off the excess. The rest of this is 6 that I forgot I had, so I only really needed to buy 4, but whatever. after all's told, we should be about a little less than a mil into this $2 million ship, so money saved eventually, but we do have to finish up the rest of the process. Oh, speaking of production, we finished that, actually, and I can turn in the, those Scourge missiles. We have 5,000 of them here for this guy. He's gonna give us another Badger. Hooray. Thanks for the other Badger. I appreciate it. You have many choices about where to go. Oh, okay. Well, thanks for the Badger. That's gonna be sold or reprocessed. Speaking of reprocessing, according to this blueprint, we need 67,000 Tritanium. We've got 12,000. We need 12,000 Pyrite. We've got 4,000. We need 7,800 Mexalium. We've got 1,400. Sorry about the frame rate. I'm doing a video compression right now. But it doesn't really matter. We're doing window frames anyway. Not frame rate not required. But to get that, we can simply reprocess some of our ores. I could buy it, or I could sell this stuff and maybe even get exact amounts and probably not be wasteful. But we're just going to do it this way. So if I put that Azure Plagio Clagio there and the Plagio Clagio there, that will get us near our required amounts, and we can put the viscous that in there, and that will get us even closer. But I don't actually want to use the viscous pyroxies because that is valuable, and I think I could sell that. We can take about half of this, so we'll go with, oh, or we could just do all of it. And that'll give us the amount that we need. So 12,000, way more than enough of that, way more than enough of that, and just about enough Tritanium plus what we have left over. So according to this thing, we'll lose a little bit of money in the reprocessing for value-wise, but I think we'll save the money by not having me derp around in the market in the long run. Plus, I like making stuff with the, you know, with the skin of my own hands, the fruit of my labors. The labor fruit is juicy and delicious. So I think we might have enough. I think we're like, yeah, we need a little more Isogen. We need exactly some more than that. I'll just go ahead and buy 40, and or actually 39, but after that, we can start producing our Iteron. I'm just going to buy it in the station, whatever the price is. And let's use the blueprint. How long is it going to take? 2 hours, and then we'll have us a ginormous Iteron Mark V, which is pretty friggin' dope. I still need to grab the skill book for this, but that saved us quite a bit of money doing it this way, using our own mining labors to make the Iteron. Gotta love it. So there you go. That's how I've decided to go about making my ship. And now we've got extra ships. We have the extra Nostalgia for Infinity here, which I can repackage now. I hope. Oh no, it's insured, isn't it? Is it insured? I don't think it's insured, actually. Repackage. There we go. Yes. All right. Now in our ship hangar, we have an extra venture, which I do want to save in case we lose the Rocinante. We have two Badgers that we can now sell. Those should, let's see, let's look at the market for these. Maybe I can transport them with the Iteron to somewhere more viable. Looks like, no, they're, okay, I could get a little bit of extra money by going four jumps away with them, but these things are big, like, how big are you? Like, size-wise, Jesus. That's, no. No. I'm going to sell them here, and I just happen to be lucky that they sell for a good price here. Let's see. What was it? 27.3 is actually very nice. Regional average is 324. Are you sure about that? You not cray about that? Are you sure you're not badger about that? Oh no, I guess they are kind of expensive to buy. But to people buying them, not so much. I might be able to mark that up. No, people are selling. No, people are buying them here. The only one for sale at this station, well. Yeah, the cheapest one for sale at this station is selling for 400 thou. So maybe I could get away for putting it up for like 300 G's. That'd be cheaper than the one four away. Yeah, we'll put a couple up for 300 G's. That's only 7% below region average. I think that'll be okay. We'll see if someone wants to buy them. Anyway, there's that. And, we're still in the good standing as far as money goes. Lost a lot of resources that we had mined there. But now we need to buy the Galente Freighter skill book or not. Industrial, that's the one we need. Yes, gives me the Iteron Mark V. How much do you cost at this station? Oh, they cost 300,000 no matter where you go. Well, shit, that's expensive, but that was an unavoidable cost. And let's see here, we're learning Mechanics 3 right now. Good skill, but I think I can make a little stopover for the Iteron. After I shoot it up like, hey, Ron. Galente Industrial. There's a 33 minute. So in a couple of hours, we'll not only know how to fly, but we'll be able to... We will have a brand new Iteron Mark V that we can start transporting stuff around. And that's going to have a lot of storage space for us to play with. So that would be very helpful, especially because I'm going to... The next thing I'm going to do is... move to a new home away from home. I'll probably keep this place near and dear to my heart. I'll probably what I'll do is leave my proof of discovery and clearance documents here and the data core. So my really valuable stuff here. But I think we're gonna move everything else to a new home area, and I've got a few places scouted out that I'm gonna have to take a closer look at before I figure out which one, but that will be later. Minor note, some of the early videos have just come up and someone has already sent me a massive amount of money, and I am going to show what I will do in that case, and that is I will try to find their name, This guy's name is R. Driftner. R. Driftner. Thanks for that. But I don't know if this is the same guy as him, but whoever it is about to get a donation. I hope this is the same guy, because whoever it is about to get that money. So please, don't send me money. I want to earn my money. Thank you. Okay, so apparently the R just means that's the thing. But, yeah. So I did give it to the right guy. But anybody in the future that does this, you're not guaranteed to get your money back. I guess this is just something I'm going to have to deal with. Thank you guys for all of your money. I enjoy getting it back. We did make some real money, though. Legitimate, selling market transactions. We sold our badgers and our mushrooms, and we sold them at the marked up price that we thought we could push it to, so that's good. So we're up to 3.2 mil real money. I don't think there's anything I can do to stop people, but also thank you guys very much for all the wonderful messages and things. A lot of people offering friendly help and advice, and that's really appreciated. And even the occasional hilarious picture of the learning curve of death. But I think I'm doing okay. Anyway, one thing I wanted to say was that I'm going to test something now that is a little weird. I'm going to bring a part of my computer online that I have not brought online since it initially failed on me. I have a 2 terabyte hard drive that I've been afraid to use because it was active during the great frame collapse of the Kerbal Space Program era. And I've been terrified to try to record to it again because of that. But having something to record a lot of is good and bad in that I usually record to a 1 terabyte hard drive, and that ain't enough. So, yeah, I'm going to try to record to a different one for a little while. It may result in the loss of some video footage. You've been warned. Hopefully nothing significant, but I'll try to keep it... keep it cool, you know? Keep it sweet and normal, I guess. Back to the business at hand, however. Our Iteron Mark IV is done. And I think I remember seeing something about some skills being learnt. Let me take... Oh, wow. Our queue is getting silly small. So we did get the piloting thing there. We have Mining Frigate 3. We got some of those little ones that we picked up from some of the... business contact missions that we did. Mechanics up to level 3, which is really cool. That'll help us modify our ships in some interesting ways. And industry level 3. Now we can learn some of our new skill books that we got from some of those missions and do more advanced industrial thingies. Let me see here. What skill books can we use now? Mass production. Shoot me up, Johnny. Advanced industry. Shoot me up with the knowledge. What about you? Mechanics 3, hey. Jury rigging. This one's good for a lot of reasons. Once you get it up to level 3, you can get drone rigging, which allows you to get a rig that I want. The small mining drone. Something or other. It's in here somewhere. No, it's not Tech 2. It's somewhere in here, and it's good for us. Small drone mining augmenter. Ship's mining drone yields the expensive CPU. So, yeah, that's a really good one for getting into what we want to get into. And then salvaging one we should get also as well because of our mechanics level 3. Lots of skill books, man. Sweetness, that's lovely. Well, I am hesitant to put them in front of the mining thing, even if they're... Well, I guess most of these are going to be, like, 20-minute jobs, hopefully. But I want to get this mining thing trained up as sap as possible. Let's see here. No science yet. We are going to need to train science a lot. It's already level 3, but we need it to be at least level 4, possibly even level 5. I still haven't trained any more in archaeology, because I don't know if there's any reason to. Oh, hey, whoa, there is a reason to. If you find an artifact, increases your chance of actually getting something out of it. I don't know what these things are for. Sleeper tech. Or something like sleeper tech. Marshals of spatial manipulation. Oh, right, okay. I think some of the wormholes and some of the other things you get in the anomalies you can get access to if you have those things or something. I don't know. Basic jury rigging is not something I'm probably going to get a lot out of. Like an emission scope? What? Increase the efficiency of a ship's relic modules. I'm sure that there's some ways that we could find to put this to use, but because it's only a 16-minute skill, I'll go ahead and toss this in here. What did we get here? Salvaging. That's a 25-minute skill. Gotta love the quickies. We have now advanced industry and mass production. I don't really know what mass production does. Multiple operation of multiple factories. Ability to run one additional manufacturing job per level. Cool. Okay, that sounds nice. Something that I think I would like very much to have, even though that's a damn. That's a important skill, actually. And then advanced industry, 3% reduction on manufacturing and research times per skill level. Boring, but necessary. I also think you need that for the advanced industry. I'm pretty sure you need that for... no, not capital ship, but... I think you might need that for running the mining barges or something like that. And I think that was all of our new skills. Oh no, we did get the cybernetics thing and we did install our charisma chip. I wonder if that's working.
I love you.
Oh, must be working. It just turned me into Barney. The electronics upgrade to level 1, no, to level 2 is not going to be terribly useful. This is something that I'm a little ambivalent about because it doesn't really do anything. Maybe I'll do that even later. But level 3 is what we want because that'll give us the hacking skill for doing the data sites if we do manage to get to it. And there's not much else to get from this except for... Oh, these are actually pretty cool. Late game things. You know, late to me. So I guess I'll move that on down, because it's not terribly important, but I would like to get that before I start the 20-hour monster of mining. 20 hours, yes. Laugh! I dare you. Alright, so that's our skill stuff. So what am I doing now is I am going to possibly pack up our shit and move. I mentioned that we were looking for a new home. We've been having good luck at the Science and Trade Institute. In fact, I think our standing with them is actually pretty good. It says 0.42 here. Oh no, that's the Caldari State. 204, yeah, with old Julian Silvestre. Which is good. I don't think that impacts our... Oh, whoa. What, are these things hurt? I don't think they are. I think this is showing me stuff. I meant to do this. I don't think this impacts our reprocessing too much. I think it'll just reduce the taxation on us. Now, I mentioned that I was looking for a home, and I have a few possible candidates. Currently, we've been in the Jovian system. I would like to move somewhere that is closer to medium security and possibly has access to low security lanes or something like that, and has agents that we would like to work with. That looks like somebody else sent me another donation. Here we go again. Well, that one came from a nice gentleman by the name of Poopicus Butts, so at least I appreciated part of it. Anyway, we've got some potential homes. All of them are very close to here. I'm not planning to move, like, super far away. But I wanted to get more into a nice area. So let's see here. I looked at this one. Oops. Oh, man, I'm going to have to say these things out loud, aren't I? Autoris is up here near some very, very iffy places. It's actually a bit on the iffy side itself, and I'm not sure I would want to stay here, because it does have a very nice, quick access to, like, Nullsec, but I don't think I'm ready for that, to, like, fully live there. It's the only other benefit is it's very close to where we are now. This one was somewhere I've been frequently going to, Isan Nomo. It's got access to a couple of, like, 0.4 is important for a miner because that's where the jaspit starts showing up, I think. So it's good to have access to that kind of area. And then this one also has the ability to go up to some of these constellations up here, which give you access to Galente Space and some other Nullsec. So that's cool, but I think I don't... There's some reason I didn't want to go there. I think there's not enough stations. Yeah, there's only 4 stations here. And I believe there's only 1 with medical stuff. It does have mining missions in it somewhere, probably from these rapid assembly factories. But, I don't know. The Kino system I was very keen on potentially going to. But again, I believe it has a very limited amount of stations with... In fact, I don't know if this one has any medical facilities in it at all, so no pod people can live here and show up here. So I think that that was what I decided to avoid. Although it does, I really like this trade lane here. Or not trade lane, but you could mine out in here and then come back into a relatively high security space pretty quickly. And have access to old Jovulin and all the Jita shit that you would ever want. There's also this one here, Sandkasin. I think this one is probably our best potential because it is relatively easy to get back to where we've been. It has some good access to some decent security spots, although nothing 0.4 in the immediate area. But this little jaunt over here is pretty good. And again, I don't want to live too close just yet to the super low sec areas. But that doesn't matter because I think the one that we were going to go with was this one in Venelin. It is itself 0.6. Now, Kino is a place that we would want to stay, but I don't know if we want to go... It's a matter of like how far we want to jump back to get to the safety of our home. And I think that Venelin might be a good spot because it had good station facilities for us to base ourselves out of. So, yeah, there's Kaldari Navy testing facilities. That's got medical for sure. There's mining outposts. So, yeah, I think that this even though it's in 0.6, which is probably about right for where I want to stay, I think that that sounds nice. Now, I want to make sure I don't... I just want to make sure there's no... Because I would really like to stay in Kino, but I don't think there's any medical facilities whatsoever. It's not required that I get medical facilities to live there. Like, I could have my pod stay exactly where it is. But, yeah, I guess that shouldn't be a qualifier. Where's the closest safe place to put a pod at? Well, as you can tell, I'm not 100% sold on this. Especially because this is sort of out of the way for shipping areas. So you can take this lane to Venelin and then go into some semi-medium sec stuff. But to get down to where we are, you've got to go through a web of weirdness. I guess that's not terribly bad. Let's see here. What would happen if I set the destination? Yeah, that's a bit wonky. A couple of unnecessary... skips and hops there. Might be able to cut some of those with a little bit of a shortened time frame. But I think that that would be a good launching point, actually. Not Kino, but Venelin, because of the ability to put pods there. It'll give us plenty of opportunities to explore around with different security statuses and lots of agent missions, and hopefully we could find a home where we would like to stay for a while and do missions to gain faction standing with a certain particular type of agent. So yeah, that's the plan. I think I'm gonna pack up our shit in the Iteron Mark V, which will be renamed something, probably the Nostalgia for Infinity, to give us a little nostalgia for the thing we sold. And then there's not too much stuff left for me to carry. I'll probably sell off these little rounded edges here, but I would like to get all these. I don't know how many of those it can hold. Probably not that many. Or maybe more, I don't know. We're definitely going to insure this motherfucker, especially... okay, yeah, 5 rig slots, that's That's awesome. Especially because I've started putting these videos up on YouTube. People are going to be hunting me down, like, specifically, which is kind of sad, because I'd like to be killed by people in Eve, but I'd like it to be natural, you know? Don't do it just because it's me. I don't mean anything. Okay, no, do that too. It's fine. Anyway, yeah, I think I'm going to start getting ready for the move. I have decided that we are going to move to the Yusasai constellation, to the Sankasen region in the Citadel. Or wait, the region is the Citadel. The system is Sankasen. It's a 0.7 sec, and if you look at the Yusai constellation, you can see that the related solar systems in it are right around where we want to be able to putter around. And it's got good access to some very high security pathways for us to do trading and things like that. There are mining agents here, mining distribution agents there and there. And also, it has access to some of the other places that I wanted to live. Like, let's see here, I believe Venelin and Kino are just a couple hops away from old Senka. It's pretty... I think it's only 5 hops from there to get to Jita as well, and some of the other major trading hubs. So I think that this will be a good spot for us to go live. I'm going to go ahead and set a destination there, and I'm going to start thinking about how I want to do this logistically, because we are going to have to move shit on a ship, and I think we're going to need to do it on the Itaron. So let us assemble it. Or not. Why can't I assemble it? There it is. And we will make it active. Let's take a look at this bad mother. Zoom all the way out. Yeah, there we go. It's a whole lot of fucking cargo ship right there. Now, let's fit it out with some modules. Expanded cargo hold. Wait. Okay, so by default, the cargo hold is 6,000. We can get it up to... And this is just expanded cargo hold 1s. You could put all of these with cargo hold 2s. But that bumps us up to 13,000 cargo spaces. In fact, we could just put a mining laser on this thing and just go AFK with it. Although it is a very expensive ship and it would be easy to lose. I don't think it also has any drone capability whatsoever. So that's not good. I don't think there's any real reason for us to put weapons on it. It doesn't even have a missile bay. I guess we could put a civilian Gatling gun on it. Just so we can be adorable. Adorable the Explorer. Oh, wait. I can't even put that ammo in there. I don't even know if I have ammo for that thing. So yeah, that's about that for this guy. I think we might want to... Can we put these in it? What does this thing even fire? I don't know. Maybe it doesn't fire anything. It's a rail gun. It's gotta fire something. I thought it would fire those slugs like that. Charges? No? Oh, well, whatever. Anyway, I think we might want to pack up some of these ships, but I don't know if you can do that without voiding their warranties. The Venture, we can definitely do. That's 2,500 cargo space. That's gonna be the largest portion of that. We'll leave the Ibis here, but I can just put a whole damn ship into the cargo hold of this beastie. I don't think we'll pack... I think we'll move these two by hand. No real reason for us to do any shenanigans with that. But we should be able to move... Let's see, I'll sell these little leftovers. Might want to just sell the Veldspar as well. But I'm going to definitely take the Viscous Pyroxes. That takes up a lot of our cargo space. I want to bring our blueprint. And you guys... And let's see if we can fit all of this on there without the minerals. You know what? Actually, now that I think about it, we could transport that in the Rocinante because it's got an ore hold. So let's see how much of this we can put into it. All right, that puts all of that in there, and that leaves us with a ton of space, so maybe we'll just put that in here too. And this, fuck it, let's just put everything in there. Whee! Jesus. Now that's a damn cargo hold right there. So that'll leave us with the Theseus and the Rocinante in port here, and we can come back and grab those individually. But this is going to be a bit of a stressful hop for us. Oh, right, I have some other mods I wanted to put on here. I have a big-ass afterburner I can put on it. And I probably should find a bullet for this. I think I'm going to find a bullet. That's a civilian Gatling gun. It literally makes its own ammo out of thin air. So I put a real gun on it. It is a electron blaster, so it's not really that real. So we have a big ship full of our cargo. It is very slow, though. It moves at 80 meters per second. And with our afterburner, it will move at 150. So a lot of this is going to come down to, I hope we don't die, but it's all very relatively high security space. It's just a matter of... It's just a matter of finding out if any of you assholes are waiting for me to appear outside and blow me up. In fact, maybe I should take a scouting trip first. But she needs a name, and going along with our hard science fiction genres, we're gonna name it the Massive from the hard science fiction classic known as Invader Zim. Alright, let's just head out of here, and man, this thing is gonna maneuver like a piece of poop. But we've got a little teeny weeny laser on it. So, don't fuck with us.
Look at how it's adorable. Is that it? That little teeny thingy on top? I think that was it.
Yeah, there's our laser. Aw, that's cute. Let us kick on autopilot. And get the fuck on our way. I love you, Science and Trade Institute. In fact, we're going to find another one of you. After I punch a hole in your hull like an a-hole. Rawr. Oh man, it even warps slow. Come on, you can do it, come on! Really? Huey? Come on. Oh, this is gonna be a rough journey. Whee! Space truckers! Alright! Also of note for this journey, I won't be using autopilot, something that was offered many times as tips to me. And I agree, for the most part, unless I'm AFK traveling somewhere, but it's better to just warp to within 0 meters of a gate and manually do the jump, especially with a big old hog like this. Because autopilot will dump you out like 15 kilometers away from the gate, whereas doing the manual warp to zero will get you, like, literally up its butthole. So... That's how I like to operate, up something's butthole, especially when I'm operating a gigantic space weenie. And we arrive at the gate, literally up its butthole. And I can just insta-jump. Or relatively insta-jump. Usually it actually puts you a little closer than that, but there's some... Yeah, look, see it. A fraction of a second away. Anyway, we're almost there. And we're here, and I already like this system, because it's got a nice deep space feel to it. Look at the little nebulas and all the dark stars, and... Oh yeah, I could get used to this. So we've got to find ourselves the... let's see here. Science and Trade Institute School here. Nice. So, I think we'll stay here as... We'll keep our pod here. Actually, I probably shouldn't go here. I should go to one of the mining places. Let me look around a bit. I want to get docked as quickly as possible, though. With something. There should be a... trading station might not be bad. What do we have here? Provisional plantation. Production assembly. Patrol assembly. Space lane patrol. Funds unlimited. Wow, I'm getting all my stuff mixed up. I'll look at the stations and see if we can find that one that would be suitable. What was that? Expert housing something? Housing production plant. Cool. Right, for now, we'll dock here while I try to find a particular station. I'm sure we can find something. I'm going to look at the actual agent listing and find somewhere that's got mining operations available for us. Alright, so it looks like the there's a couple of mining... agents in the area for the Kaldari Provisions warehouse, which is a part of the Kaldari state. I don't know if that would be a whole like global thingy, but I think that'll be a good place for us to hang out in the long term. And then there's also distribution at the housing production plant, and then there's also the Mercantile Club. all Caldari State stuff. A couple places to go. Not only that, but there's also... there's also agents available for us for mining in Halima. Oh wait, no, there were. Maybe there aren't any more, I don't know. Oh, maybe it was this one. Yeah, there's a couple mining agents there. And then there should be mining agents over here as well. So all we've really got to do is find some good corporations and start working for them to gain reputations and loyalty points and start reaping the rewards of our reaperage with me. Naturally, forgetting how to get back to the station, I made a little mistake, and I forgot that we're going to need a shuttle. But it's okay, the shuttles are super cheap. I picked one up here for like $5,000, and I'm going to go to the station where it is held and grab that and then fly that back, and then probably make a few more trips. I might even want to buy a blueprint. You can get blueprints for standard shuttles for incredibly cheap, and all they take to make is tritium. So no big deal. And we are going to the Space Lane Patrol and Assembly Station to pick up our shuttle. And I'll be back once we've transferred all the rest of the stuff over. Pretty damn cool looking shuttle. I'll give it a temporary name, Zodiacal Light. Probably won't stick with this ship. We'll probably use that name for some other ship. But for now, we're just going to carry on with this thing. And again, sorry, I lied. But I will be back this time when we're done. And I hate to say it, but I'm gonna miss this thing. This is quite possibly the coolest looking ship I've seen in EVE yet. The Caldari shuttle. Oh yeah. Dope as heck.